Hey folks, this is Best in Slot. Welcome back to Jurassic World Evolution 2. We're going to pick up right where we left off at the end of the last mission in Pennsylvania. We've established the home base for our dinosaur farm safety and nature reserve, let's call it. I think that's more appropriate. People are going a little bit crazy. Let's find out what we do in Mission 4. Here we go.
This is what we'd hoped to accomplish on Isla Nublar. A place where the dinosaurs could finally thrive. Minus the volcano. Obviously.
That's a pretty big minus.
I think we can all be proud of what we've accomplished here.
But?
But what?
I can hear it in your voice.
Okay. I'm just wondering what Dua is really up to. I don't buy all her saving the future by controlling the past talk.
Yeah, Lambert mentioned that some of the animals were being moved to an undisclosed location. He wouldn't say, or maybe he didn't know who was taking delivery, but it wasn't the DFW.
A third party?
And you and I are not invited.
I'm glad that other people are picking up on it as well. Oregon, the reports of contested airspace in the PNW and the DFW have been called in to capture flying reptiles to protect them and local air traffic. Awesome. Oh, beautiful looking as well.
First reports were from Seattle-Tacoma Airport's air traffic control, but now we're getting radar hits from Portland International. So they're traveling south.
Probably because of the weather.
Agreed. They're migrating. But what happens if one of these animals decides to play chicken with a commercial airliner?
This is the modern world and the prehistoric one on a collision course.
That's beautiful stuff. Very excited about this. Construct the following aviary dome. Awesome.
If Owen and Lambert do what they say they can, we're going to need facilities in place for the flyers when they arrive. Let's start with some aviary domes and a hatchery. Oh, we also need an expedition center. And as you heard, time is not on our side.
All right, Claire, I just wanted to take a little peek around the map, but I guess not. Aviary complex of domes that can house flying reptiles. Aviary domes can be snapped to the edges to form a single complex. Each complex needs an aviary hatchery, and aviary viewing galleries can be attached as well. Okay, let's get a move on. Very exciting. Let's get this expedition center built. What was I going to say? I was going to say words. They're going to be great words as well. You just have to trust that whatever I was going to say would be insanely interesting. Oh yeah, the story's picking up a little bit. It's interesting because I'm very curious about how this all links together with, where does the story go? Is it just, let's save the wild animals? But no, Dua is obviously up to something because Dua is always up to something. The girl can't be trusted. Oh, we need to research it. Okay. Does it look like a problem? We've got a... I've got my same scientist. I like that. There's a nice bit of a continuity going on, you know? Which I think is pretty cool. Yeah, I like that a lot. I've lost all my research though, which is sad. Oh. Alright, speed up time, I guess. There's not really much else to do at this point. Every dome on the way, so we can take a little look around the map. Really nice, very pretty. Could definitely see some, you know, bears doing some salmon fishing here, that kind of thing. This is our Tega map. What was the last one? Maybe it was grassland. I'm crazy. Oh no. Anyways, done. I've never built one of these before. This is literally the first time, so I'm pretty excited. Wait, where's the entrance? Is there an entrance? I don't know how that works. Maybe it's where I connect the path. It probably is. So I'm going to put that there. Oh, look at that. That looks really cool in its, like, basal form. Okay. I'm obviously confused. Does it need the hatchery to work? Oh, there we go. Oh, right, so it doesn't have a building animation. That's why. That's what was throwing me for a loop. Oh, look at this. The research version doesn't have the glass. It's more like a chain link. Something big just banged. There's a storm outside. I feel like I'm in bloody Jurassic World. Twister's gonna ravage me. But yeah, there you go. This is the research version. Oh, that's why there's no entrance either, I guess. Because why would we need an entrance in the casual way? Maybe there's never an entrance. Is it? But no, there usually is.
Ready on this end. We could send out expeditions for remote capture.
These creatures can cover a lot of ground from the air, so we should snap to it.
All right, let's fly the not-so-friendly skies.
It's interesting. There doesn't seem to be a, Remember, there used to be a button to... Well, it would let you snap to the, to the path. Like, buildings would snap to the path. That doesn't actually seem to be a thing anymore. Incident alert! Local authorities have captured flying reptiles near Oakland. We need to send a live capture team to collect them. Yes, we do. 5 Pteranodon near Oakland. Sweet! So I swear, logistics are by far the most useful. Let's go. I just feel like everything uses logistics. Welfare feels like the least useful. Ready to
deliver. Have them brought to the aviary hatchery by our transport team. We'll then release them into the domes.
And by release, you mean contain?
Yes. In a controlled environment and under our supervision and care.
Excellent.
We should be on schedule to deliver assets to the other site.
Could have a little break. Okay, cool. I need a ranger team to check this. So the hatchery, this is why a hatchery is required. Although, of course, it's less required here because we're not actually hatching anything. But the hatchery is also the scan point for the aviary. So here we go. 5 out of 5 captured. Pteranodon looking really cool. It is the short-crested Jurassic World version, as you would expect.
Transportation underway. Asset has been collected.
I suspect this is too small, but tell you what, let's increase it. Wow, that looks really cool. I just wish there was more of an animation going on, but it does look really good. I really like the kind of, I don't know, rudimentary aesthetic it's got rolling. Ranger team, let's get you rolling over here and let's get you renamed. Thank you very much. You are my drive boys. You know, if I'm going to use the same scientists for the entire game, I feel like my capture team and my fly girls should always be the same as well. They've been with me since the start. Hello. So here we go. This is the aviary. Very cool. Oh, you're lonely. You won't be lonely soon. Don't worry about it. Awesome. Absolutely awesome. Yeah, big fan. Do you need... Yeah, you've got loads of environmental needs. Okay, let's get those fixed. So we need some... We're going to need some water because we're going to need fish.
Asset transported.
Let's get them a feeder. In water. Oh, right, yeah. I was thinking, is that not requiring shallow water? What? Wait, what? 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 Oh, wait. Wait, what? It's many times since I say this and think I've figured it out. It throws me through. There is a little bit around here that will work. I'm a little confused by this, I'm not gonna lie. Is it... Oh! They sit on the ground! I'll check you out in a second, I just want to make them happy first. Do I need to put more water in or less, is what's throwing me. I'm gonna put more in first. There we go. Then we need to cut into this a little bit, because that's a little bit crazy for my liking. Okay, don't know why that wasn't working, but hey-ho. Okay, we also need some rock. Oh, rocks count as rock. That might not sound like a particularly confusing thing, but it's worth noting, I think, that they count and it works together kind of thing, you know? Put that around there. Not quite enough. They actually need more water, interestingly enough. Not much, but a little bit. And we can either use the rock texture, like so, or we can put rocks down. There we go, happy pteranodons. Let's see them eat. Oh, get off. No, come back. Come back, please.
Looks like we might be getting things under control.
I would say famous last words. But given the number of times that I could have used this very phrase over the years, I'm going to go with, quote, predictable, unquote, last words instead.
Dr. Malcolm. Why are you contacting us?
Same thing as always, the dinosaurs. And my obsessive need to witness the car crash when it happens.
It's good to hear from you again, Dr. Malcolm.
Ah, Dr. Dua, you're now increasing the so-called intelligence part of the CIA, if I'm to understand correctly.
We do what we can.
Yes, yes, we do what we can. And sometimes more than we should. Interesting times. And I mean times as the dinosaurs are living in ours. Should they be here? No. Are they? Yes. Ergo, they should. And the hidden hand of chaos is revealed.
It's what else remains hidden that's concerning me at the moment, Doctor.
Oh, yes, indeed. Yes, yes. And that's why I've brought somebody with me to help shed some light in this regard, Mr. Isaac Clement. Yeah, a specialist of the spectacular. You should be hearing from him soon.
These dinosaurs require feeders if they're to stay healthy. Stay on top of it.
Oh, Claire? I mean, what do you call this then? Claire? Hello. No. Very cool. Oh, you're done? Only one fish. And they sit on top of it. I love it. Wait, they're all there. Bear with me. I want to have a look.
I'm Isaac Clement. Dr. Malcolm should have mentioned me earlier. We have some specific requirements, including a ranger team to gather information and monitor the animals within the aviary. A viewing gallery is also on our list. So, now it's on yours.
Interesting that they're not viewable, even though all five are currently sat on top of the bloody viewing gallery. I think we probably need another one, realistically, to kind of cover the area. I want to cover as much as possible. I think that one, or that one. Probably that one. That should cover everything, right? Yeah. We need a little bit more power, but that's fine. Interesting it doesn't have power, even though it's connected. Ah, it's going to snow! Oh, beautiful. There we go, yeah, sweet. I think that one might be grabbing the men away, but, you know, why not? Is this the level we saw? We saw a picture of an aviary covered in snow and all frosty during the preview for this game. I wonder if this is part of it. Ah, isn't that awesome? Hello. Sitting atop that viewing gallery, not a care in the world. You're just going to do what you want, aren't you, buddy? Yeah, they look good. They've got nice textures, nice colours. We'll come check them out again in daytime.
I've been thinking.
You think it makes me nervous?
No, seriously. Why the flyers?
Okay, I'm not following you.
Dr. Malcolm starts contacting Dr. Dua from who knows where when these flying reptiles become an issue. Why?
Because they introduce a unique danger? And peace concerned?
Yeah, that's probably it.
Let's not get ahead of ourselves, Owen. For now, we should make sure the satisfaction levels for the flyers is high. That's verifiable data we can use. Forget the conspiracy angle.
Whoa, we're chasing prehistoric animals, Claire. Reality ain't what it used to be.
It raises a good point. I hate to say that about Chris Pratt, well, fake Chris Pratt, but he raises a good point. It is very interesting. And then he brings in Isaac. Why would he trust Isaac of all people? Interesting. We'll see what happens. We'll see where it goes. I'm actually intrigued by the story at this point in time, which is something the last game never really managed, if I'm totally brutally honest. So I'm curious to see where this goes. They fly, they float, they do things, it snows. Doesn't cover the ground though. It's not a snowstorm. So it's not blanketing the ground in snow. Which I think is a bit of a shame. It'd be nice if we could get like some partial cover, maybe that would be pretty cool, but yeah, it's not a big deal. Can I have decorations yet? No. It's because we're not building a park, right? We're just...
Yeah, you were right, Dr. Malcolm.
It's sort of my thing.
The facility is functioning as anticipated.
We have enough assets in the pipeline that we should be able to move forward soon.
Right now we're putting out brush fires, but this is an inferno that could engulf the world.
Your concern is noted.
For now, I suggest we focus on this location. It's about high welfare and visibility for the animals. And safety for the DFW staff, of course.
Learning to coexist with the dinosaurs is a process. We're getting there.
And if we don't, where's that leave us? we will have created an apocalypse born of our arrogance. Humanity versus the dinosaurs, and honestly, I'm not sure who deserves to win.
Interesting. So they're all up to something. These three are kind of in cahoots. We know that there's a third party, and apparently that third party is Ian Malcolm, and he's been working with Isaac, and they've kind of brought Dua into the fold, and she's working for the CIA, sure, but she's also working with this third party to establish something.
If we want to find success, we must look to the sky. That means more flyers, and more species of flyers in the aviaries. Flap, not flop.
I think I'm rolling with the Dimorphodon, because there's six of them, and six is cool. Let's go with Dimorphodon. There we go. Oh, Uchida, you're going to have a break after this, okay, buddy? Now, can they live together is the question. No dislikes. I think if they've got a large enough habitat, it'll be fine, basically. They need the room, otherwise there will be problems. I'm going to make a really funky-looking aviary. It's going to look crazy. I love it. One of the first things I want to do in sandbox mode, I haven't got there yet, is just see... Just how big can you make an aviary? Just how big can you make a lagoon? Can you engulf the entire world in those things? I hope you can. I think you probably can, actually, but I'll have to wait and see. God, this night time's lasted forever, hasn't it? It's a long bloody night. That's what Game of Thrones is trying to worry us about. It's interesting. We'll find out where it's going to go. There we go. Looking a little funky. Looks like a... What does it look like? It's like a bear with a... Never mind. Never mind. Right, what I want to do, actually, is build another feeding area so that hopefully the Dimorphodon and the Pteranodon can establish separate territories. Oh, maybe I should have done it over here. Can I put it over here? I'll do it over here if I can. Just so they can separate themselves and not have any problems. You really need to go hard on the water. Wait, can I do this? Oh, nice. Oh, that's pretty cool. It's like a Jurassic Park 3. Very cool, actually. Alright, let's do that. Get rid of this one over here. Hopefully that should keep them nice and separate. We're going to need to chuck in a bit of rock as well, I assume. Do some of that in there. Want a little bit. They don't need forest, but I just think it looks pretty. So, you know. There we go. How many did we get? 6 found? 6 captured. Awesome. Okay. Yes, please. Bloop, 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 bloop. You can see I've got 11 out of 79 dinosaurs at the moment. Although there are 84, technically. I do have the deluxe edition. Okay, let's see how this goes. We're probably going to need another viewing area as well. That is not the right button. Let's try that again. Yeah, well, you're always in water. You just don't get over it. I mean, it already... it's close. I'd like to put it there. If I can bring in the water a little bit here. Don't think that's going to work, but we'll give it a go. No. Alright. They're quite hard to find. Wait, why are you over here? Missing fish. There we go, Dimorphodon, looking lovely. I'm going to have to come check you out in daytime when I can see you properly, but... Oh, they need sand, interesting. Okay, well, we'll do what I said then. I'm going to put the sandy stuff over here. That's cool, they require different things. Again, just trying to keep them away from each other a little bit. You see, that's the Dimorphodon territory right now. It's cool. So that's the... Wait, how big is the Pteranodon territory? That's Pteranodon territory. It's fairly huge. Dimorphodon territory is kind of... They're overlapping right now. But what I want is the Dimorphodons to move over this way. Preferably. Because they're saying they're missing sand. But I think that's because it isn't in their territory. And as it flies over here, you should see that sand number. Yeah, you go. Look at that. It's a pretty cool idea. You can build multiple habitats, essentially. Within one habitat, in a way. And it just needs to fly over there and get its fish. Because at the moment, its territory still includes that fish feeder. I want it to include that one. And then we'll be good. It's pretty sweet. It's pretty sweet. Didn't get me the score I needed, though. Although, we'll keep going up. We probably need to do another expedition. We have to get another one, right? We have to get a new species where possible. Go. Uchida, my friend, do you need a little bit of a break? You've gone a little bit crazy. Control center. Let's get you a rest. And I think we probably need to expand this again. It's going to end up looking a little bit mad. Why not? Why not? And I'm going to put the viewing area in nice and early. Like there. It doesn't seem to gain power from the aviary in the way that it would from other things. You know, like when you have an electric fence and you attach a viewing gallery to it, it works, right? That doesn't seem to be a thing with the aviary. Absolutely ginormous in here. Very cool. Alright, so we want this area over here to hopefully be the Tropognathus area. I need a bit of forest. You don't want it to look too boring, right? So a little bit of forest just brings it all to life. If I just make weird noises, people will probably leave the video, actually. I should stop. Why don't you load up a video and it's just me just going, meh, for the entire thing. Be like a little rocky area over there. Alright, let's go check out these Dimorphodons. We've not had a good look at them. They're all hanging out together. This was the opposite of what I was trying to achieve. At least they can get on, though. Hello, Dimorpho. It's quite hard to get a lot of light in this one. I think this aviary probably obscures the light. Wait, how are you going to fit that in your mouth? Oh. With great difficulty. I really like how this Dimorphodon looks. It actually looks better than the film version to me. It's better than the Pteranodon in some ways. It's got some great colours to it, some great details. I'll try and get a good shot of it. I just want them at the feeder, really. Very excited for hopefully a... go, look at how the textures really are better. I know I've mentioned this a few times, but it's a big step up, I would say. They look really cool. Everyone seems happy. Right, let's get our tropes in. How many did we get? Oh, one got away. A renegade is wandering off on their own now. I'm going to drop them here, see if that makes a difference. And that's one more for the sticker book. Funnily enough, I had this conversation with someone yesterday that if you go back in time... Why are you low health, buddy? No food, no water. I mean, that seems like your fault. I'm not going to lie. There is food if you want it. And there is water everywhere. Put another feeder in, I guess. Seems like a you problem, though. I'm not going to lie. I can't even put another feeder in, anyway. Squeeze another one in? No. They'll be fine. They don't seem to be moving.
In optimum condition. That means making sure they have the food they need. Don't let them go hungry.
Do it. It's not my fault. It's unironically not my fault. It's a dummy. It's just doing what it wants to do. Instead of what I tell it to, which makes it silly. I'll build a paleomedical. It seems to have stuck. You know, it doesn't seem to be moving. And it's just dying over time. And I don't know how I fixed it, honestly. And it's ruining it because my dinosaurs don't have comfort. Well, I say dinosaurs. Captured flyers. Where's our tropes? There they are. Wait, are you on the roof? I swear I saw someone on the roof. Trope. Oh, look at this colour. Oh, beautiful. With the white? I've never seen that before. And the red over the snout? Very cool. They really are just all hanging out together. Proper little party over here. Jesus, they love this thing. Absolutely surrounded by them up there. Right. How does this work? So is this what the drone does? Oh, cool. It actually drops them into the hatchery. So even with the live capture, you do still need the hatchery. It opens up at the top. And they drop in and then they fly out. That's pretty cool. And it closes. Yeah, nice little detail. Right, what do? You park up here. And then you send out the drone. Yeah, there it goes. This Pteranodon has not moved at all. It's just bugged, I think. It's not healing either. Look. Oh, no, now it is. Finally. It's still starving, though. Hey, and it's moving! Oh, right, maybe we'll be okay now. Okay, I need some screenshots. You're going to have to forgive me, folks, but it is a necessary part of the job. So we need a nice shot of the aviary, which is quite difficult, because it's a funky-looking thing, to say the least. Just going to grab a few. It's just because the level will end, and unlike in the last game, and this is probably something they should change, to be fair. There's no option to continue. There's no option to just keep playing the level you were playing, which you could do in the old one. You just keep playing the island. But even if you weren't doing that, you could go back to the island. And this, we have neither option. It feels a bit of a shame, actually, that we can't continue playing on the map we've been playing on. Seems like a fairly obvious option to include. I don't know, maybe when we finish the game, we'll have the option I'm just grabbing a bunch of shots. Maybe when we finish the game, we'll have the option to replay the levels we've already done before. Right, you're starving. Let's get you some food, eh? Come on, buddy. You can do it. I believe in you. Yes? Promising? There you are. I'm so proud of you. Who's my favourite Pteranodon? You're my favourite Pteranodon. And I'll screenshot you for immortality. Well, that's not a very useful screenshot, but you need to feel good about yourself. I'll give you a cool name. Like Blaze. Because that will give you confidence. Oh, I want to see how the trope eats. Let's hop into capture mode. This guzzles it. Right, well, watch this one. I kind of messed that up a little bit. Oh, excuse me. Gives it a little wiggle. Oh, it lost it. Oh, cool. And then it gives it a little rah, rah, because it's angry about the fact. Oh, that's cool. And then it flew away, though. I feel like it should stay and eat some more, you know? I really like the trope. It looks pretty awesome. Wow, that was super quick. This is what I mean. I need more screenshots. I'm not finished. I didn't get enough shots of the creatures to make a good thumbnail. And now, because I can't load the level, I'll have to replay the entire bloody game to do it. Right, well, that is mission 4 complete. My concerns are still here, because I think that's 80% of the campaign, so I don't know what's going on, but we'll have to wait and see, I suppose. Let's check out Mission 5 in the next video. I'll see you there. Yeah. Thank you so much for joining me either way. Again, hope you folks are enjoying this playthrough. Throw me a like down below if you are. Subscribe to the channel, check out the playlists, leave a comment, leave a like. What else do YouTube people do? Subscribe to my OnlyFans. Thank you for joining me. Cheers much of as always. Bye-bye. Reaching out.